just a quick second. I'm Sheila Hogan, one of the sponsors, and I want to thank all the sponsors, of course, Mary Caferro, myself, and my husband Jim. Jim's back there. Jackie Hill, or Jackie, thanks Jackie. Chuck Hunter, is he? There's Chuck. Tammy Pilcher, where's Tammy? Thank you, Tammy. And Kylie Keene and Mike Greig. Thank you, everyone. Thanks for sponsoring. This is really a great location, and it's a beautiful night. As I said, I live in Jefferson County, so I really don't claim my representative, no offense. But here, I manage Career Training Institute in Helena, and my career was really built on helping low-income people. And who are low-income people? They're women. Helping low-income people find their place, find their way, become self-sufficient, and really contribute to this economy. That's how I built my career. So when I talk about my senator, I consider Mary Caferro my senator because she fights for the people that I work for. So I have the pleasure of introducing Mary Caferro. Thank you, Mary. First off, thank you everybody for coming. Thank you for getting involved in a primary. I know that's not easy to do. Some people do that. I think primaries are good for the party and they strengthen it. Nothing wrong with that. But most important, I want to thank Jesse for running and Jill and his son for being supportive of that. That's really important to have a supportive partner and family. And so thank you. Okay, so first up, everybody knows who I am and what I do. And for the past 12 years, I've been advocating on behalf of low-income people, mainly women and children. And so when Jesse decided to run, he didn't even have to ask me, but he did. He was courteous enough to call me and ask me if I'd support him. But I knew hands down I was going to support him, and I'll tell you why. Going back to 2001 and 2003, when he was a freshman legislator, I was working as a grassroots organizer, and as you may remember or not, our budget, run by Republican governor, no offense Republicans who are here, but under the leadership of a Republican governor, a Republican Senate, and a Republican House, was $250 million in the hole. And so working on human services was not fun. We had a list 32 pages long of budget cuts. So when we went into the 2003 session, my job as a grassroots organizer was to engage low-income people in the process, and I was really busy. And we were busy trying to find sponsors of amendments to restore the cuts across the board to all kinds of essential services. That wasn't an easy job to do when you're talking about 32 pages of cuts. And so what happened was Jesse came up to me with his big round eyes. I didn't even know who he was. He didn't know who I was, and he said, I want to have an amendment to restore child care, the cuts to child care for working low-income people. And I said, say it again? Are you serious? And he said, yep, and I was told to talk to you. I need to know everything there is to know about this issue. Where do we find the money? And I'm going to move it on the floor. It's really important to me. And so what is important to think about is we as legislators, we as lobbyists, are always educating each other, trying to get people to support our issue. But what's really special about him is he just had the initiative and he had the heart to decide that was what was important. And I will never forget that, and I will always owe him. So that's why I'm supporting him. The number one population of minimum wage workers, adult women. The highest rate of uninsured women, 18 to 24-year-olds. And who's on welfare? Women and small children. That's a really important issue. The economics of being a woman is really important, and this guy gets it. And that's why I hope you will help me in welcoming and thanking Jesse Laslovich. Yeah.